What's going on, guys? It's Lomax here, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Borderlands 2 as Axton the Commando. Now, you might not know where we are. I know if I was playing the game for the first time, I would have no idea where this is, but then again, I would not know where anything is if I was playing it for the first time. We are in the Ore Chasm. This is kind of an overlooked area. Yeah, most people, I would say most people don't know about, but I know what, personally, I don't come here that often, but this is home to the Hyperion Slaughter Dome, and I figured that'd probably be a good thing for us to do, maybe gain a level or two. Sorry, I was looking at that class mod, and it buffs our grenade and explosive damage resist, but doesn't give us steady, so pass on that. But anyways, yeah, this is innuendo bot.
Has reprogrammed me for tournament hosting and sexual innuendos. You could almost say she increased my hard drive. Flirtatious eyebrow raise.
I just wanted to let him finish that. I was gonna say, he's the master of sexual innuendo, but he pretty much said it himself. But I figured this would be a good place to level up. I don't know, maybe not level up. Well, we probably won't even get a level out of this whole thing. Maybe we will, I really don't know. But it would be good for fighting. We might get to 28, and if we get to 28, I'm happy. I don't think we'll finish all five rounds, though, in one video. But, we'll see if we can. But this Slaughter Dome is very, very, very loader heavy. And then you have engineers, too, but, you know, mainly loaders and surveyors and constructors, so all stuff that the stink pot can cut right through, or smell, stink right through. So, we'll be relying on this gun a fair amount. First wave, it looks like there's just a bunch of gun loaders. I don't expect this to be too bad, especially with all these corrosive barrels here. Man. I don't know if that's RNG or if that's intended. Make our lives a little easier, I really don't. I do not know. Okay, I guess it's RNG. There's an explosive barrel right there. Unfortunately, you don't get a lot of XP from doing these quests, because it is 5 quests, so if you did, it would be a pretty hefty amount of XP. Most of the XP you get from this is from killing the actual enemies themselves. There are 5 rounds, if I am not mistaken. I think there's 5 rounds in every Slaughter Dome except for the Tiny Tina one. Magic Slaughter Dome. There's 6 rounds in that. The last one's a badass wave, which is annoying as hell. And we probably will never do that in this Let's Play because it's a miserable time. I do not want an ogre that badly. Especially with Axton, it would be awful. The only way I do it is if I'm in UVHM and I do the normal mode one. We might be able to get through a couple rounds. I don't really know. I don't know how long it takes to get through these. Oddly enough, too, I just had a free playthrough when I did this, and you'd think I'd know, but I don't remember things like that. I just kill things with free. I turn into, like, a meathead with Krieg. Just lose the ability to think. And just focus on killing things. And the Lyute is still one-shotting people, so that's very useful. 2 waves. Wow, we're almost done with round 1 already. I know it definitely gets a lot harder. Especially when you get ultimate badass loaders and all sorts of fun stuff. Or I guess they're supers in normal mode. But this Lyute will be great for surveyors, because those guys get annoying later. But we are, again, I say this and I keep forgetting every time I say it, we're in normal mode, so generally things that are a problem later aren't so bad in normal mode, but things that are a problem in normal mode are super duper bad later. There aren't really too many problems in normal mode. I can't even think of any off the top of my head. I don't know, maybe you guys have ideas of things that are bad, but I just can't think. The Glutton of Thresher can be annoying, I guess, but that's only if you're underleveled. Otherwise, it's not too bad. really, you know, a matter of whether or not you're underleveled or if you have bad gear. Maybe not bad gear, but not ideal gear. Make sure we go in with full ammo on everything, especially the Lauda and the snake bot. Still have that Hulk? I think I do. I'm gonna switch out the little Eevee. I'm not a fan of it. Still have to look up what it does. I can't remember. I know it's something with cooldown rate. It might lower your cooldown rate or something. Shooting an enemy or reloading or something weird. But I know it has to do with cooldown rate. That was round one. Pretty easy. Round two is probably only gonna be slightly more difficult. I don't see us getting through all five in one episode. Maybe round three, maybe starting round four. I don't really know. We'll see. We got maybe a little less than 2 bars of XP from that one round. No, I think we can get a level out of this definitely, and hopefully we don't die. Hopefully we live long enough to see level 28. That'd be pretty sweet. This is always just a fun area for mobbing. If you love mobbing, I definitely recommend this area, the Ore Chasm.
That was cool.
The only thing I wish it had was the ability to replay it. Kind of like the, that's what I love about the badass wave in the Tiny Tina DLC is you can replay it, even the Holodome, you know? I don't necessarily like the Holodome, but I like that you can at least replay it. The badass wave in the Holodome isn't too bad, it's just the earlier rounds that are kind of slow. I think it's way too big. And if you guys don't know what the Holodome is, it's basically the equivalent of this, but in the pre-sequel. It's a giant water dome type thing. With all the enemies in the pre-sequel. The new one specific to the Holodome, which is kind of cool. Like the bulwarks. They're just monstrous. Monstrous beings that I think go invisible. Or something like that. Yeah, and I haven't played it a whole heck of a lot. DPS in general, I just haven't played a whole heck of a lot. Nothing... I can't say I dislike the game. But it doesn't grab me like Borderlands 2 does. I don't know what it is. Oh, are we gonna die already? We have a PBFG. This might save our ass. Oh yeah, totally did. I don't have any health though. We're wave two. Wave two of four. I never know what it is about pre-sequel that just makes me not want to play it. I don't think it's one thing, it's probably a whole bunch of things that... I don't know what it is. This doesn't have the same feel. I do think they did a lot of things well with it. The characters, I think, were... You know, I think they were great. Their skill trees were pretty. I think they're better than these ones, honestly.
Success.
The synergy was there. Very creative too, with a lot of the skills that they could use. Like, I mean, Claptrap's action skill. Okay, well, how you say? Yeah, they were so creative. They copied all the action skills of all the characters in Borderlands 2, but. The fact that they had more than that too, you know? They had, I don't know, 10 different action skills in one action skill. And RNG determined which one you got. And it was kind of, they kind of modified the skills of the characters. They weren't exactly the same. I don't know, the game was just lacking something. For me, it's... Can't quite put the, you know, my finger on it. Alright, we're very much on fire right now. So, let's try and be less on fire. I think we're less on fire. Maybe the same degree, but to a lesser intensity. Oh, nope, we're on fire. Oh, no! I was hoping he would die, or I would go down before he died, but that's alright. He didn't die. Stink pot, slow projectile, though, kills me. Probably shouldn't be using the stink pot either against this guy. This should one-shot him. Excellent. Oh no! You can get knocked off, which is very scary. As you can tell by how frightened I was there. I do love the music, though. That's like probably my favorite part of this whole slaughter dome is the music. Fuck fighting things, you know? It's all about the music. Put good music in the game and I'm sold. It'd be the worst game in the world. Alright, this is a problem. Everyone went around corners. But that's, I believe that's what the P stands for in this thing, is problems. Problems forgotten by gun. Oh no, sorry, it's BFG. Problems be fucking gone. Probably what it is. That guy didn't die. We do have a turret too, I keep forgetting about this. At a certain point when I play Axton, I just kind of forget about the turret. Usually that's around UVHM, but I guess we've hit that point a little early. I'm gonna try and be less of a scrub. Because if we're struggling in round two, we're probably not gonna make it to round five. But we'll see. We got another almost 2 bars of XP there. Not the greatest. Maybe we'll get more in this round. I don't know. I hope so. I really do. Sex. Also, I did want to say, I don't know why I didn't mention this before. We did hit 200 subs the other day, and I just want to thank you guys for, you know, watching my shit. Basically. Sounds gross, actually. Thank you for watching my videos. But I really do mean it. I appreciate the hell out of it, and I hope you guys enjoy content. I hope you continue to enjoy the content. And that's all I really want, you know, is to just put out entertaining content, so. Thanks, everyone. All awesome. And let's kill some things.
The circle of slaughter is beginning. No more 4, 5, 4, 3.
Oh man, all the innuendo in this DLC is great. Some of them are, I mean, okay, not some of them are pretty forced. Most of them are pretty forced, but... Oh, okay, that was almost bad. Starting off hot. Okay, really, really hot.
Super hot.
One PBFG shot takes out, like, all these guys. Yeah, maybe not all these guys. It takes out the exploders, and that's good enough for me. We have 5 waves this time. I think the stink pot should work here. It's not gonna reflect back in my face, at least I hope it won't. Doesn't seem to be doing too much damage, though. And unfortunately, Metal Storm doesn't really help us unless we were using, like, some sort of macro to fire really quickly. Because we can't really... I can only click my mouse button so fast. Uh-oh. What are you, Exploder? Exploder! What do we got? Hot loaders. Hot cops from Arrested Development, I don't know why. Okay, they're gonna catch us in a drug bust or something and then try and take their clothes off. They're not wearing clothes though, so. He doesn't understand the reference. You should watch that show, it's hilarious. A lot of people didn't like the later, like the newest season. I thought it was interestingly done. They did everything based on a character rather than an episode. It felt different. I don't know. That's the thing with resurrecting shows. They're never gonna feel quite the same as when they were on originally. Like, you know, we mentioned Full House the other day. It was, I heard that was basically, you know, it never went off the air. The same cheesy humor, just everyone was aged 30 years. And there were no Olsen twins. Hello, Jet Letter. Oh, yeah, I forgot about this. If we get the super badass surveyors, there's a weird glitch where they get stuck over here. I don't know if they spawn in this round, though. We'll try and, try and get that to happen, because it's pretty interesting. What else we got? Yeah, that exploder, where are you? Are you? Oh. I don't know what I was gonna say. Oh no, that sound the jet loaders make, it's the same as the exploders, and it scares the living daylights out of me, because I always think there's an exploder right on my ass or something. You need to die. We got now. Engineers.
Bandits attack at the end of my shift.
Oh no. Oh no. Uh-oh. Oh god. I almost just lost it. So I've noticed sometimes that if there's a dead body in front of a live body, your bullets can still hit the dead body and it will not go through the live body. It's happened more than I would like to acknowledge. No. More than I would like. Anyway. It's actually really frustrating, especially if you're trying to get a second wind or something. And then you get blocked by something you already killed. Halfway there. Living on a prayer. Hey, surveyors. Ion Loader City. I just keep thinking to myself, I'm gonna regret doing this as Axton once we hit the OP levels. Be hawking all day. That's the strategy. We got regular surveyors, now dead surveyors. I hope I'm not a dead accident in a matter of seconds. I think all that's here in this wave is the surveyors. Might be mistaken though. Where's my Lauda? Lauda! I can get one of them stuck. Not happening though. I don't want to play. Or yeah, we definitely got more experience this time. Ooh, instructor. Light is actually gonna be way better here. Once we get these surveyors out of here for okay, never mind. I lied. Let's do that. Are you a badass? Maybe we don't get badass surveyors yet. Pretty sure the last time I did this, there were badass surveyors in this part of the mission, but that also was at UVHM, so I don't really know. That is round 3. Not too bad, and we definitely got more experience that time. 2.5 bars, maybe? So we'll definitely hit 28 if we can actually finish this, but we're gonna finish it in the next episode, guys. That is gonna do it for this one. We'll just turn this one in. Mel will probably say something. Mel. Whatever this guy's name is. Innuendo bot. Mel's the other dude. He's on the other side of this door. Masterful. Alright. So, thanks for watching, guys. As always, feel free to rate and or comment down below. Also, feel free to subscribe if you would like to see more videos. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll catch you next time.